Hello everyone, how are you all? I hope you all are doing well. So I welcome you again to your English class. And today we'll continue with chapter number 6, that is The Little Bully. This is part 2 of this chapter. And if you have not seen part 1, you can check the link in the description box. So let's get started. But before moving further, let's recapitulate part 1 of this chapter. Actually, this is a story about a boy named Ravi. He was a bully. He loved to tease all the children in his class. He even used to pinch and prick them very hard. That's why everyone hated him. Okay? One day their class went for a picnic to the seaside. Everyone was very happy. They sat with each other in the train. And even when they reached the seaside, they played with each other. But nobody talked with Ravi. Nobody played with Ravi. This made him very angry. So he went to the sandy corner and sat there all alone. He decided to have his lunch. But as he opened to eat his lunch, he heard a very strange and rough voice. And as he turned around, he saw something that made him frightened. So to find out what frightened her, what was that thing, let's continue with this chapter. So look at the paragraph number 5 on page number 40. Ravi saw a monster crab walking sideways out of the pool. His eyes were on the ends of short stalks and he looked most queer. He held out his front claw to Ravi. Ravi put out his hand to shake the crab's claw. But to his surprise and anger, the crab opened his pincers and nipped his hand so hard that the little boy yelped in pain. So here the word monster means unusually large. The word crab means a sea creature with 5 pairs of legs and a round flat body covered by a shell. The word stalks means long thin structures that support organs in some animals and join them onto other parts. The word queer means strange or unusual. The word claw means one of the sharp curved nails at the end of each of the toes of some animals and birds. The word pincers means a pair of curved claws of some types of animals. The word nipped means gave somebody a quick painful bite or pinch. And the word yelp means to make a sudden short high sound, usually when in pain. So this paragraph tells us that when Ravi turned around, he saw a huge crab walking on the side of the pool. And that crab was looking very strange. And do you know that crab held one of Ravi's legs with his claw? You can also see it in the picture. And when Ravi tried to get rid of it, the crab opened his pincers and pinched Ravi's hand so hard that Ravi shouted loudly in pain. Now look at the next paragraph. Ah, here is my good cousin, said the crab pleasantly. And to Ravi's horror, he saw a large sandy lobster crawling heavily out of the pool. Before the little boy could stop him, the lobster took his hand in his great pincer-like claws and pinched it so hard that Ravi again yelled in pain. So here the word pleasantly means happily. The word horror means fear. The word lobster means actually lobster is an animal that lives in the sea and has a long body covered with a hard shell, 2 large claws and 8 legs. And yes, tell me one thing. Have you ever seen a lobster or a crab? Do let me know through the comment section below. Okay. The word crawling means moving forward on the hand and knees or by dragging the body close to the ground. And the word yelled means shouted loudly. So the crab felt very happy and even he called Ravi his cousin. And do you know, Ravi also saw a huge lobster crawling out of the pool. And this made Ravi more frightened. And as he tried to stop him, even the lobster also pinched Ravi very hard. And Ravi again shouted in pain. Now look at the next paragraph. Then he stared at the pool in surprise. For out came sandy-colored shrimps and prawns, more crabs and another large lobster. And they pricked Ravi till he was soon black and blue with their pinching. So here the word prawn means actually it is a small sea animal with a shell and 10 legs. And the word shrimp means, actually it is also very small sea creature similar to prawn, but smaller. Okay. And these are the pictures of shrimps and prawns. And as you can see that shrimps are just like prawns, but they are smaller. Okay. So while the crab and the lobster were pinching and pricking Ravi, the other sea animals also came out of the pool. And they also started pricking and pinching Ravi till his skin turned blue and black. So now look at the next paragraph. "Don't you like it?" said all the creatures in surprise. "Why? We were told you would love to see us because you were a champion pincher and pricker yourself. Come join in the fun." So here the word creatures means animals and the word champion means excellent. So all the creatures who were pinching and pricking Ravi asked him whether he liked it or not. They even made fun of Ravi by telling him that he was an excellent pincher and pricker, and they even invited him to compete with all of them. Now look at the next paragraph. "Ravi leapt to his feet, crying loudly. His lunch rolled into the pool, and when the crabs and lobsters saw it, they ran to it and began to feast eagerly. Ravi saw that they had forgotten him for a time, and he turned and ran for his life, tears streaming down his cheeks." So here the word leapt means jumped. The word feast means to eat a lot of good food and enjoy it very much. The word eagerly means in an interested and excited manner. And the word streaming means moving and pouring out in a continuous flow. So when Ravi faced all this, he started crying and ran away from that place. And as he ran away from there, his lunch rolled into the pool and all the sea animals enjoyed the lunch. Now look at the last paragraph. "They only did to me what I keep doing to the other children," he thought. "But how it hurts and how I hated those crabs and lobsters. I suppose the other children hate me too. Well, I jolly well shan't pinch or prick anymore." So in the end, Ravi realized that just like he hated all the sea creatures for pinching and pricking him, the other children also hated him for doing all this. So he decided that he would not pinch or prick anyone now. So this was all about the story, The Little Bully, and I hope you have understood everything. And this story teaches us a very beautiful message that we should not tease others. And if we are doing it, God definitely teaches us a lesson in some or the other way, just like the God taught a lesson to Ravi. So this is all for today. And if you have any doubt, any question and any query, do let me know through the comment section below. So see you in the next video. Till then, take care all of you. Stay safe, stay healthy, and thank you so much for watching.